White House expected to announce new aid package to Ukraine. Well, the U.S. is the richest country in the world. I think Ukraine's neighbors should have all stepped up a long time ago. But if somebody's got money, it's the U.S. I don't think all these are gifts. I think a lot of these things have strings attached, and loans and things too. All right, that was CNN. This is Fox News. This is what they're saying. London war. Biden to lift Title 42 despite warnings from Dems. That's what the graphic says. Kenny and Bishop E. Evans. I heard somebody, a soldier or a guard, border patrol, somebody died trying to save an immigrant. That might be what this is about. Del Rio, Texas. This guy's some kind of border patrol agent, I think.
John, the other thing is that, you know, the death of this
search continues for missing National Guard soldiers.
Well, there's a risk, not only to the agents on the ground.
At Eagle Pass, Texas.
What's happening, there's also a risk just to people on the road. It's unchecked when people are allowed to flow across the border. Basically, without any inhibition, we face a lot of rancher property gets destroyed. We have vehicle chases that go through our communities, and the agents move around.
Chicago police are facing record low recruitment rates as a result.
Yeah, the police department is looking for someone that's really cool as they bring in a fellow U.S. Marines. Yeah, we will have all the details coming up next.
There's, I think people that take those sorts of jobs know it's almost like being a soldier. And they're ready to lay their life on the line, and that's what happened, I think. I don't know how he died. They searched in the water, maybe he drowned. Or maybe he was attacked by somebody. They say some people do human smuggling across the border. So maybe he ran into a human smuggler with a gun or something. I just got the tail end of their story, so it's, he could probably write books about all the things that happen around the border. Drug tunnels, and I've seen stories with immigrants in wheel wells of cars. Some of the stuff they say is just hype and it's not happening so much. Like, I don't think it's dangerous for Americans to cross the border and go to border cities. And they've said it is for a long time, like for visiting Tijuana from San Diego. They've kind of tried to scare people. And I've always felt safe down there. I've probably been there 2 dozen times, maybe. And then also, probably a dozen times, I went a lot further than Tijuana. I've always been safe there over the years.
The U.S. Supreme Court today returns to the question of prayer in public schools. The justices will hear arguments in the case involving a high school football coach in Washington State who was reprimanded and eventually lost his job for quietly praying on the field after each game. Let's bring in CNN Supreme Court reporter Ariane Cho. Ariane, good morning. This is the second time this case has actually reached the high court. What are you watching for today?
Right here. This case did recently come before the Supreme Court, and the justices did so with merit, and several of the conservative justices, they suggested they were sympathetic to the coach's case, because the coach, as soon as he started his job back in 2008, he started quietly
about Ukraine's troops and winning. And Twitter executives now said to be taking Elon Musk's bio offer seriously. Could have changed their minds.
That's interesting. It's interesting how the left and the right both like Elon Musk for different reasons. I think the left sort of likes him for his liberal views, like with clean energy and also like maybe this solar panels, electric cars, and innovative tech stuff. The conservatives like is more because he's rich and they think he can make his own rules. And that he'll be a better protector of free speech than Twitter. Who knows? The truth is probably somewhere in the middle. He's probably good at what he tries hard at. He probably doesn't mind wasting a little bit of money or time here and there, too.
Joey, if you're looking for a group of well-trained individuals, typically fit discipline, know about weapons and self-defense, that's a great start.
Because he makes money hand over fist like every second of every day. So he loses money on something. He's still always making residual money. I guess Twitter stock already made $800 million since about then. Tried to wrap your head around that. Chicago's Lincoln's 20th Marines address. I think some of these cities like Chicago used to be conservative red areas a long, long time ago. And they're liberal blue areas now, and the conservatives kind of want them back. Or just find conservatives in those areas to talk to anyway. And they like to criticize certain things. This news is different. This is in the signature.
That he was considering doing so. The reporting confirms that. Here's more that January 10th, 2021 conversation.
Mixture of what 21st century American fundamentalist Christianity and conservative libertarian.
Thank you.
Kevin for who he is, it's not like he really trusts him. We should also know Trump has not yet endorsed McCarthy's bid to be Speaker of the House if Republicans take control of the government this fall. Joining us now, White House reporter for the Washington Post, our friend Tyler Major. Tyler, good morning, great to see you. Let's start there. Just get your reaction to the latest in this ongoing saga of Kevin McCarthy and Donald Trump. It certainly seems to be just the latest example of the tight Trump's hold is over the Republican Party.
This is disinteresting to me. This isn't the news, this is just speculation. Now they're talking about White House claims Biden's approval rating. I don't care about Biden's approval rating. CNN, Russia's war in Ukraine.
Almost 200 billion transactions that were blocked.
CNN is devoting a lot of reporters' time and energy to the war in Ukraine.
It seems like a shipping terminal boss, Mark Andreessen, is on the front lines enforcing sanctions. Any vehicle bound for Russia, valued at over $55,000, is impounded.
I got the job, guys?
It could all add up to potentially billions of dollars of goods that could be used to help Ukraine. But turning it into cash requires legal confiscation. Not an easy process. European parliamentarians are being warned by EU justice officials.
To get somebody's property. Seems like a couple great bands are losing a musician that don't know what to do right now. Switchfoot is losing their guitarist, Drew, and sadly, Foo Fighters. Drew is quitting, doing something else, and Foo Fighters lost. Taylor Hawkins, your drummer, it's because he died. So if those two bands are going to continue, they got to replace those people. I think Foo Fighters might come back with a vengeance. And I think Switchfoot will alter their sound a little bit.
Alright, let's bring in
Fireman's at an oil depot in Rush's Bryant Street. To the 2 a.m. local time, it got hit. It's pretty close to Ukraine. So they missed the protector. Russia strikes fire real estate issues as it's for election. Yeah, just look at both of those things.
This is no mistake by the Russians. This is absolutely deliberate. They're trying to cause the people to lose confidence in their ability to use these facilities and to escape the Russian crimes that are going on in their own country. This is not unlike...
A record small number of refugees fled on Easter Sunday for Orthodox, which was yesterday. Only 3,000-ish people got out of Ukraine, according to the UN, so... They might have only had one train or no trains or something, and there might have been a ton of people waiting to go today. And Russia probably knew that and wanted to wipe them out, I guess. Or somebody.
In terms of their ability to win, the first step in winning is believing that
right.
You can win.
Right. And so, we can win. Perhaps they were waiting there because they couldn't get on the train. Because there wasn't one on Easter Sunday. Or perhaps they got there early, or they're going to get there.
Journal, what's your reaction to that? Do you think the Ukrainians have what they need to win?
I'm sure it's the 2 a.m. 2 a.m. is the Russian one, and the oil depot, I think. Not sure what time the trains are here. I think it was overnight. Just said overnight.
About
I've never taken a train, choo-choo train before, but I've taken trains like in Los Angeles County and Long Beach, like go above and underground and stuff like that.
For real. At the appropriate speed and more importantly, at the appropriate place. We're finding that putting it.
Some of these are actually like old choo-choo type things. I don't think Russia is trying to stop them from the pollution, from the conclusion. They may be trying to terrorize the people, try to get the people not to leave. There may have been weapons in those trains.
Thank you.
May have been soldiers in those trains. Or they just thought there were. Or they may have been mad at them. Hello, God. Oh, God. I think I'll listen to it. Apparently, he knows how to sell stuff to Elon Musk.
Musk came back and he said, I've secured $46.5 billion in financing for a tender offer.
Musk is going to be just like any other world leader, and it's all going to depend on who he surrounds himself with. Whether this is great or whether this is a disaster. He's not going to have all the ideas all the time, all the energy to do everything. It's going to come down to who he delegates, who he trusts.
It's like
Twitter's tripping out. They tried to prevent him from buying it. And then I think he asked everybody to sell tender their stocks to him, which means they're selling them personally. So he'd have a majority in on it. And now they're listening to him about his offer.
Thank you.
I used to play basketball when I was a kid at the boys' club. And now it's called the Boys and Girls Club. I've got real long arms. I play some basketball too in downtown. Muni gym, municipal gym. Center court, as much as people. Pick up games. Got some guys like Duncan, some guys wearing jeans. My friend played on the basketball team and he took me down there. I like playing on the jam hoops, like the elementary school basketball hoops, the 8-footers and stuff. And you could just slam the hell out of them. I used to play pickup games and do that for hours.
Thank you, Andy.
On the pavement, elementary schools. On the weekends or whatever. Some of these countries, I like to visit them. They seem very, very strict, at least in word, you know. But I wonder if in practice, indeed, if they're actually, like Saudi Arabia and their religious police, I've heard of relaxed, if a younger leader. And I wonder if China's like at the more softer cave, still kind of philosophy. Because people seem to listen to them, the government, real closely, and they seem, so maybe they get a lot from them, or they're afraid of them, or both.
Right, Selena, thank you, appreciate it. New airstrikes on train stations in Ukraine.
Oh, there's no country like the U.S. It's
and a sheriff's deputy heroic climb to save a baby.
When you go from the U.S., it's hard to understand. It's hard to understand certain countries when you go from the U.S. that are nothing at all like the U.S. I've asked my Chinese friend if he wants to visit China with me, and he said, yeah, maybe we'll have some time. He's American, Chinese. His parents were born in Asia, and they brought him over here when he was little. We became friends, we've been friends for decades. And he speaks Mandarin. And I'm not sure if he's totally 100% fluent, but he speaks Mandarin. Yeah, I'm sure he's fluent, so. He married a Hispanic wife, and they lived sort of in a, it was towards the Mexican border. I should ask him if he practices his Mandarin, if it's good or how rough it is. His name is Charlie. How funny is that? Charlie. Charlie. Hawk commercial is. Sell me drugs on TV. Bipolar depression pills. Jesus, man. That would be such a last resort. Popping pills or something. They should legalize plants and make all these things open source. If they really take their Hippocratic Oath seriously. So people can make their own whatever they want, whatever they want, however they want, as often as they want. Make their own plants and their own synthesis. Yeah, no need for these blue pills. Look, these Democrats seem pretty united in this war issue. So, you know, they all work in states, people elected them, and that work for companies that make money on selling these people weapons or advising them. And they've been playing the, they've been contributing to a narrative of that makes Russia's the boogeyman, the scapegoat for a long, long time. So this just fits really easily into everybody's narrative on the left and the right. Probably sticking it to the people they didn't like. Dangerous firefighters climbing up a burning building. It could collapse. Ashes could fly out. But it shouldn't go. There's just a fire at the very top, I think. Firefighters, yeah. This is at night time, so the video's not real good, but it looks like it shows somebody climbing over a balcony and grabbing somebody about a floor or two before the roof.
Here's what he said just a short time ago.
At that moment, I knew that I had to save the baby. I didn't know how I was going to do it.